guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a Cetaphil cleanser review video. Now I have filmed this video already I think twice and I wasn't really happy with the way it came out, and today I have a big acne on my face, but it's not gonna stop me even if I have hundreds of them, because today I'm determined to do it and I will. So I'm gonna let you guys know how it works and how it has worked on me. Now I have used it for almost one and a half years. So I'm gonna give you guys a complete review. Now before that, please subscribe to my channel if you are new here, and yes, let's get started with this video. So now Cetaphil brand is something that is really known to a lot of people. The products from this brand is available really everywhere, online and offline. It is available in every possible shop, like medical shops or like a cosmetics shop, or anywhere it is available. And the moisturizer from this brand is really famous, and a lot of people talk about this. Since I myself don't use a moisturizer a lot, so I haven't purchased that, but this is something that I have been using for almost one and a half years. So I thought this is a good time for me to give you and share my opinion on this product. So Cetaphil comes in two variants and two sizes. One is for oily skin and one is for dry and sensitive skin, and the sizes are these two. This is a small bottle. I think this is 125 ml and this is 250 ml. The price of this is 387 rupees and the price of this is 431 rupees. There is not a lot of difference between the packaging, apart from that this is not translucent and this is slightly translucent, and the bigger one comes with a pump and the smaller one does not. It has like a cap like this, and both are convenient and they are not travel friendly or whatever. I mean, I have tried to travel with it, they both leak, so be really careful while you're traveling with this. Either put it in a plastic bag or and tie a knot and carry it, or like transfer it into a smaller container and then you can carry it however you would like. So my skin type is basically oily skin mostly, and why I got the dry skin one is totally by mistake. Actually, I didn't want to get this one. I actually got this and I really liked the face wash, and I had used this every single day, and so I thought I will buy a bigger one because I already love it, and anyways I'm going to use it, so I bought the bigger one. But since I was in a hurry, I did not see that there is a different variant in this. I thought it's all the same, and I picked the dry skin one, and I just noticed like a while later. But anyways, I didn't want to waste it, so I tried it. I didn't want it to risk also, but I tried using this. But the thing is, I used this mostly in the winters. There's still a lot left in this. I use this mostly in winter. It did not make my skin oily or greasy. It added good amount of moisture. Also, this is not a face wash that will add you like a greasy amount of moisture on your face. It will give you like a gentle moisture, so which is really what I wanted. I didn't want it very much of moisture on my skin because it is already very oily. This is really good actually, but I'm not gonna say there is nothing else that is better, 100% better than this, and I'm not saying that this is the best product of all, but this is one of the best I would say, because if your skin type is oily, usually you would like to purchase some cleanser that takes away your oils from your face. But sometimes what happens if you use a product that will dry up your skin, it might take the natural oils as well, and then your skin starts to produce more oil and your skin will become more oily instead of being dry. But this face wash, as I have seen, it does not dry up your skin. It will just take away whatever extra oiliness extra moisture that is on your skin, not the natural oils, so which is really really good. After using this, you really don't have to use a toner as well, and this is a non-cosmetic brand, so it's not gonna harm your skin and you don't really have to worry about it. A lot of dermatologists also recommend this one. I think the reason why they recommend is because this is one of the drugstore version where it helps you get rid of, not exactly get rid of, it will help you with reducing the acne. That's the main purpose of me starting to use this, because I have acne on my skin and I try using all the good products because I don't want to risk it. So this helps reducing the acne, it calms your acne down. But if you have like small bumps or anything, it will definitely help you get rid of the acne as well. So you can use this. I use this in the mornings. I want something that works throughout the day, so I use this in the morning. It is very very mild and gentle on your skin. It will not produce a lot of foam and it will not make you difficult to wash it as well. It is very easy to wash off and it kind of removes all the dirt as well along with it. And as I said, this is a non-comedogenic product, but the thing that you don't have to use toner because it is a non-comedogenic product. Let's come to the downsides of this. Yeah, there are a couple of downsides for this product. That is, as I said before, this is not a travel-friendly product. You can't really travel just by taking it this way. Next downside is that it has paraben. Now, paraben does not really suit a lot of people. Basically, paraben is a preservative. If paraben does not really suit, it is, if it is something that is harming your skin, so please contact your dermatologist, then only use this. That is the complete review of these products. If you have any questions regarding this, please leave them in the comment section down below. I will try to answer if I am aware of them. That's it for today's video, and I hope this video was helpful, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.